So flu season and COVID-19 on a collision course this year, and that's why it's more important than ever to get a flu shot. But when should you get your flu shot to maximize protection from the virus? So we have Dr. Frank Esper, an infectious disease specialist with the Cleveland Clinic, giving us some insight this morning. Doctor, thanks for being with us. And my first question is, what kind of flu season first are we preparing for this year?
You know, we really don't know what to expect from the flu this year. Everything that's going on with the coronavirus also affects the influenza virus. You know, when we looked at what happened down in Australia, things actually didn't have a terrible flu season because everybody was socially distancing and everyone was wearing masks. We expect whatever we're doing with coronavirus is going to affect all these viruses, but we can't take that for granted.
We've been talking about this all morning, Doctor, about timing out this flu shot because of the COVID pandemic. So is there a day, a time, a month of when we should be getting it so it has the greatest effect on us?
You know, the best time to get it is as soon as possible. Okay. It actually takes 2 to 4 weeks for this vaccine to actually get full effectiveness in protecting against the flu. So we are ramping up our vaccine efforts just today in Cleveland Clinic, but also all across the region. We should be talking to our doctors, getting our vaccine as soon as you can.
What about any special considerations, like if you've already had COVID?
You know, if you've had COVID, you know, distantly in the past, it shouldn't affect the vaccine and how well it works, and you should be able to go in. Obviously, if you've had coronavirus recently, then you need to talk to your doctor. It's probably best if you're in quarantine not to get the vaccine until you are safe to receive the vaccine and to be around other people.
All right, now what about kids, pregnant women, and also seniors?
Right. These are the people who are at most at risk of getting really, really bad flu. Under the age of 2, over the age of 65, if you're pregnant, if you have heart problems, lung problems, immune problems, these are the people that influenza causes really, really bad disease. One of the best things that this vaccine does is prevent you from being hospitalized, prevents you from getting into the intensive care unit. And so this is one of the reasons why we really focus on these groups, to make sure they don't get really, really sick.
Doctor, explain this. We keep hearing this is COVID, this is COVID, a simple cold. Everything's COVID now, so everybody's confused. So kind of break up maybe the similarities and even the differences between COVID and flu season as we head into it here in the next month.
Well, the answer is you really cannot tell whether or not you have one virus or another just based on many of the symptoms. There are a few things that suggest coronavirus, but anybody who has fever, anybody who has headache, anybody who has cough, runny nose, stomach problems, that could be any number of viruses, including coronavirus, including influenza virus. Flu does tend to have a very, very high fever, 102s, 103s, as well as a lot of stomach upset that coronaviruses don't have as often, but they still can. The answer is always that if you're feeling sick, and you think that you're coming down with any virus, you should assume that it's coronavirus in addition to influenza virus or any others and talk to your doctor.
Okay. Before I let you go, the AstraZeneca vaccine trial, we talked about this week. Now it's been halted because of a spinal cord issue with a participant. Just your quick thoughts, even concerns about this and where they're headed with this vaccine.
Well, I think this is actually not too unexpected. It happens in a lot of different types of medication trials. If there's any event that may or may not be associated with the vaccine, they usually stop the trial and do an investigation to see whether or not the vaccine or the medication had any cause for this. And so until they feel that it's safe to continue, they're going to continue this to hold it. And until the investigation is done. It's not too surprising. It's one of the reasons why vaccine trials take so long, because we really focus on safety.
Yeah, you don't want to rush it, that's for sure. Dr. Esper, thank you. We appreciate your time from the Cleveland Clinic this morning.
All right, it's good being here. Bye-bye.